Hey, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios and welcome you into the studio. Jared Lazerson, the president and CEO of MGX Minerals, and he's also with MGX Renewables that will soon be its own public company very soon. Jared, first of all, great to have you here. Thanks for being here.
Nice to see you, Steve.
So let's talk about MGX Renewables, because just recently announced financing for this company. It's obviously being spun out from MGX Minerals. So tell me about Renewables.
Sure. We just closed financing yesterday, $2 million, in support of a new listing on the CSE. We're just waiting final exchange approval.
Right.
That's expected shortly. Financing's done. This is for use of proceeds is essentially for advancement of mass production of our zinc air battery. This is one of the lowest cost batteries, say, in the world. I don't like to make the broad statements, but yeah, certainly the category of zinc air batteries, primarily because the components are very low cost. Zinc versus lithium and cobalt, for example, being primary metals, essentially battery metals used. So best in this case to go to the website, mgxrenewables.com, understand what we're doing. But very simply, as with all things MGX gets involved in, this is one of the biggest markets in the world. We are in a fundamental paradigm shift to renewables. Policy is far outstripped technology,
right?
But there is plenty of solar out there. There is plenty of wind out there. It will continue to grow. Also in BC, we have the great advantage of hydro, a renewable source. But the bottom line is there just is not enough batteries. There are essentially no batteries out there on the large scale. And that is because of cost. Lithium is just too expensive. Vanadium is just too expensive.
Zinc is, and
the idea that we would ever have a shortage of zinc, especially with our friends down the street, one of the largest zinc producers in the world being here in BC, being headquartered here in BC, lots of zinc available. And who knows what happens with the zinc market? Maybe a good time to be in zinc, I don't know, but certainly a good time to be in renewables, particularly mass storage batteries, very large, scalable. And ultimately, a separation, and this is really the technology advantage of flow batteries, or of our type of flow battery, the separation of energy storage, which is essentially in a tank,
right,
of zinc and potassium electrolyte, as large as you want. I mean, there are physical parameters, but we can imagine, we know from oil and gas, tanks can be very, very large when,
yeah,
they have fuel in them, and there's some value to that, in this case, energy, separated from the fuel cells, will actually produce the power. So your kilowatt hours, which is your energy storage, is separated from your kilowatts, which is your output. And
right,
as well, we can scale the charging. But the point is high flexibility designed for very high capacity and very long duration, and take advantage of both renewables, as in off-grid or independent sources, but also within existing sources, peak shaving, which allows you to store in the night when there's not a lot of demand,
right,
and acquire energy at low cost from the grid, and then be able to offer it to customers or in an arbitrage scenario. So really potentially adding significant capacity within the same number of power plants, within the same transmission grid, because we're able to take that power offline in the night and bring it back online. And the batteries themselves can be very close to demand. In fact, we envision a lot of our batteries in the industrial space being actually at the customer, or the equipment, they would buy the equipment from us, but really at the customer's site.
Okay.
So you don't need new transmission lines or power plants into the foreseeable future if you buy enough batteries. And so I'm talking about just very big things in terms of infrastructure and,
sure,
the paradigm shift, both to renewables, but also in creating greater efficiency within the existing power grid and transmission lines. Potentially no new transmission lines, no new power plants for many years into the future, just because of all that power. I mean, think about the nuclear, think about all these power plants that don't shut down in the night.
Yeah.
At 5 o'clock, you don't walk out and turn off the power of the power plant.
Sure.
The turbines are gauged generally for one speed.
Absolutely,
This is the way it's efficient. But I've heard, and don't quote me on this, Steve, but I have heard that upwards of 50% of power in North America is wasted. So don't quote me on it, but we know a very, very significant amount of power is wasted because the power plants are basically on all the time.
Yeah.
Why not store that in batteries and then release it during the day when we have the need?
Well, we'll see what happens with that, but it's interesting technology, that's for sure. Now, let's go on a couple of other things I want to talk to you about really quickly. First off, Petrolithium. Tell me what's going on with that.
Petrolithium finally got a landmark deal done. This will be The first commercial petrolithium deployment. We have a fantastic partner in Pennsylvania. Also just a great location. So happy that we could launch in a area, really probably one of the older industrial areas and really a potential, and although we're obviously a drop in a bucket, of a theme that's been going on for many years, which is how do we bring jobs back to areas where industrial production and factory production is just in decline for many decades.
Right.
So again, a drop in the bucket, but this could be one way in that we are now taking wastewater, or we will be taking wastewater. We've already tested it. We've already done the basic piloting. So we're getting ready for deployment here. It's a fairly large facility. They process about 10,000 barrels per day.
That's Eureka Resources, yeah, right?
Eureka Resources, yes. And we've entered a partnership with them actually for the entire Marcellus and Utica formation. So very specific basins where we know that there is significant lithium. Within the wastewater, we're able to, as a result of Eureka's existing facility, get a concentrate, which allows us for much higher grades of lithium as feedstock. So the feedstock that's going into our extraction system is around 1,000 ppm, which is equivalent to some of the highest grades in the world, equivalent to a South American grade. So very kind of interesting little pieces to this in the details.
Right.
The big picture, though, is we're just very excited to be deploying petrolithium. We're very excited to do it in the eastern U.S. and really focus on that formation, which literally goes from New York State all the way to West Virginia. So that's where the big expansion, I think, in petrolithium is going to be. And just again, couldn't be a better place. Fantastic support. And we really look forward to developing the eastern seaboard in the U.S.
Well, we look forward to hearing more about that as that continues on. We'll get an update on that. Just before I go really quickly, big award for your company recently.
Yes, Global Petroleum Show in Calgary yesterday. We received the 2019 Environmental Award. So, interesting
justification for what you've been doing.
Yeah. Well, it was. It's really nice to get a nod from oil and gas. I think that a lot of things are going on in Alberta right now. There was just a change of government. Business is, I'd say business is on, but it's not that. Ideas are on. There is just a great momentum right now in the province of Alberta, and I think in Canada generally, but certainly in Alberta, to really look at how the energy industry is going to look moving forward and to be at the forefront of that, where I don't want to say the previous government. I think they actually probably got the ball rolling
right
with this. So, right. And I'm not particularly political. I really just focus on growth for our shareholders, obviously, but it's very interesting what's going on in Alberta right now, and I think this is kind of a bit of the sign of the times to come, where it's not a pure oil and gas province. It's really an energy province, right, that is now involved in all aspects of energy, including clean tech, because that's certainly what this is for. Clean tech really combined with obviously lithium extraction, which in its own way, as we know because of the electric vehicles, lithium being a cornerstone of the new energy business. So this commitment to energy diversification, which started in Alberta many years ago, even decades ago, we're starting to see it. And we know that big oil and the big energy companies are very interested in everything that we do. They're on the same page, and whether they do it with us or on their own, these areas of clean tech and of new energy in particular, whether it's battery commodities like lithium or whether it's mass storage, for example, batteries themselves with MGX
right.
Renewables,
yeah.
We're really seeing a shift and an acceptance fundamentally that electrification is underway and that there generally will be less hydrocarbons burned in the future than in the past.
Well, congratulations on the award, and lots happening with the company. Great to catch up with you. Thanks, Jared.
Thanks so much.
Good to see you. Yeah, Jared Lazerson, the president and CEO of MGX Minerals, and of course, MGX Renewables as well.